I was cruising down the street, four deep, three bitches, one yapper on me. In the yapper might well be a fiend, cause it got two arms and some feet. Cause it wake up in the morning and it eat. I love my chopper and I think it love me.
Hey Instagram, what's up? Y'all know what I fucking hate? When regular people have babies and keep posting the back of their neck. Like, we just all sitting here waiting for the premiere post of your baby's face. Like, you're a regular nigga.
Ooh, you're not even famous. We don't even care about your baby's face.
At this point, your baby's a hostage. Keep posting other little body parts, throwing little hints and shit. Like, you want somebody to come find this nigga and rescue him. Take the blanket off his face. At this point, you're trying to kill him.
Boo, he can't even breathe.
All because you're trying to hide your baby face. We don't care. We don't care. Post your baby. Post your baby. Post his face. We don't care.
Yeah, my DMs is like, bitch, I don't need no fucking frauds. If you knew you weren't going to be a wildin' out, why would you lie? She a phony ass bitch. Corey Holcomb said it. She not going to be on there, so she not on it. She not even funny. She didn't make the cut. Shorty not even on it. I watched that shit for nothing. She really doing a Bow Wow challenge. Her and Bow Wow really like brother and sister. He be lying, she be lying. She not even on the show. At least Bow Wow was on the show. See, that's why she leaked them nudes. She leaked them bitches herself. I don't give a fuck. She put her own nudes up because she knew I and I was about to come up, and she knew she wasn't gonna be on it, so she had to get something, some type of publicity. She needed a stunt, she needed a scandal. Then, because she did the BET Awards, she thinks she's supposed to be on Wildin' Out, niggas going to tune in. She not even on it, she hella phony. I didn't even see her at the BET Awards on a red carpet. For one, the carpet wasn't even red, it was gray. So I wasn't on the red carpet, nobody was on the red carpet. Secondly, stay tuned.
Okay, so y'all wanna talk about the news. First off, let me tell y'all something about me. I've been getting attention since I was born up this bitch. And I've been getting famous attention for quite some time now. I don't need to leak no news for no fucking publicity stunt. Who do they think I am? I wouldn't leak my news because I don't feel like that my body is the leaked nude type yet. My nigga, why would I leak these? They don't even move. Let me show y'all motherfuckers something. Even my sports bra is padded. Why would I leak non-nudable titties? Like, I'm not even finished all my consults yet. And then just on some serious shit. Nude photos could possibly limit where you go in your career. And I'm just starting. So you never know whose desktop that would fucking end up on. Why would I do that? But I know a motherfucker who loves this body. All right, actually a couple motherfuckers who love this body. But one in particular right now. Chris,
I know you're about to go to work, but I have a question, okay?
But last night, when you came in, I went through your pockets, and I found this, okay? What is it?
Jess, that's for work.
Oh, it's for work. Okay, but see, I flipped it over, and it said Sheraton. Sheraton is a hotel. That means you got this from a hotel, because we have regular paper here. So what this tells me is that you wrote this while you were in the hotel room. But who are you with? Nobody gets hotels by themselves, Chris. Chris, who are you with?
Jess, I was checking out the floor plan.
The floor plan?
Yeah, I'm thinking about buying one.
You thinking about buying a hotel?
Yeah, well, Sheraton.
Hey, fuck you think we the St. Patrick's out this bitch? I got a floor plan for your ass. You're sleeping on it tonight. See ya.
Ooh. Look at me. Fit on fleek and everything. Look, y'all. Look, don't you hate when you fucking go to the club and a bitch got on the same fucking outfit as you? Like, real shit, like, bitch, like, you in my skin? Like, did you know what I wanted to wear today? Like, for real, I hate that shit. That's why when people ask me where I got shit from, I'd be like, it was a gift. Dead ass. I don't know.
Yo, Jess, you ready? Come on.
Yo, you a fucking clown, son. Why do you, what you mean again?
Not again, yo.
What the fuck? You want to be like me so bad. What you mean your store? You don't even have a store. Bow don't have a jet. You don't have a store. Like, what? Then you got on the same shoes as me. Like, you want to be my sister so bad. Fuckers, we Tia and Tamara Mowry out this bitch. What is wrong with you? Fuck, we Jessica and Jasmine out this bitch.
Jess, you ain't got no socks on.
So what? I don't wear socks with Hirachis, dummy.
Let's go.
I'ma fuck you straight.
Good afternoon, it's Jess with the mess. And my news is real. R. Kelly pays $730,000 to settle unpaid tax debt
The IRS is tired. No, we're not trying to be rude, but nigga, your taxes is due. I mean, at least he paid it. Or all the cougar moms would have a Pied Piper tax tour to attend. So sorry. Finally, finally, finally! This woman has broken the record for most annoying celebrity. That woman is Brandi Norwood. So now Keke Palmer's second. Boo, they're both annoying. It's a tie. So sorry. Dwayne Wade and Gabrielle Union go on a vacation as they dress alike every day. Dwayne just cuts the top part of the romper off. Okay, so here we have Dwayne in the coochie cutter floral. Whoop, you better tuck that testicle. Something that we haven't spoken on is some of these new relationships. Congratulations to Amber Rose and 21 Savage. He's such an angry bird. And Karrueche is now dating Quavo. Karrueche!
Good afternoon, it's Jess with the Mess. And my news is real. In response to Beyonce's Lemonade, Jay-Z drops his new album, Sweet Tea. The couple is expected to do a collab album next, Jumbo Half and Half. There are a lot of mixed reviews about Jay-Z's album, as he has a lot of people fucked up. Well, he's overrated as fuck. It's not like he's Beyonce. I take that back. Sorry. I don't understand anything about the album. He's so fucking rich. He raps in another language. Rich. Boo, what are you even talking about? This man is on a different caliber of life. While I'm trying to figure out which bottle of water I want to buy, he's trying to figure out which one of the four oceans he wants to purchase. Then he finally, finally, finally admits that he cheats. Well, we knew that in the elevator. Sorry, damn it. Then in the album, he says something like, I'm ugly, but I'm a billionaire, so I can't be ugly. Or, definitely ugly. The album is in theaters across the world. I'll wait till it comes on cable. Man, it don't even feel like 4th of July over here.
Sure, no, I am smelling
food. Man, I feel some type of way, so I'm going to sing on it.
Sing that shit.
I remember.
She remember.
All of those cookout fields.
Cookout fields.
Cutting peat on a grill.
On the grill.
We parted from 5 until.
But nowadays.
Nowadays.
Niggas say the grill is too high.
Too high.
They'd rather run around and get shy.
Get shy.
What about Frankie Beverly?
Now everybody claim they bad and bougie, but you got a BED with no box spring.
Box spring.
Bottom of your feet dirty, cause your flip-flops from Old Navy.
Old Navy.
And you smoke regular weed.
We're just gonna call you Reggie.
And your boyfriend sells CDs. And you got STD.
Good evening, it's Jess with a Mess. And my news is real. Young Buck climbs from under a rock to tell the world that he was actually considered for the Tupac role in All Eyes on Me. But he never got the script, he said.
And I was supposed to play Bobby Brown in a new audition movie, but I never got the script. Or the haircut.
Boo, you don't even look like Tupac.
It's a challenge.
Hey, Young Buck of G-Unit. We're strongly considering you for the role of Tupac.
I know it's not April 1st, but we were just kidding.
So sorry. Kevin Durant to re-sign with the Warriors for 2 more years. And $53 million. Durant received a message from Billy Donovan this morning. The message quotes, hey, big head, ... You want that old thing back. I don't blame you. Old famous group, B2K, is about to get back together to do another tour. Now, don't do a tour. Do a bio for Lifetime.
Nah.
Well, without Omarion, on their music will be bump, bump, bumped. So sorry.
Hey, y'all ever notice how no matter what, bitches always find an excuse to drink? Like a bitch will drink to anything. Bitch, I just got the job. I need a drink. Oh, bitch, it's Friday. I'm getting a drink.
I just graduated, class of 17. I'm drinking.
Oh, you a Gemini too?
Oh, bitch, we need drinks.
I'm off today. I need a drink.
Bitch, it's the 5th of July. Like, I need a drink.
Bitch, I'm sober. I need a drink.
I just got out of church. I need a drink. Bitch, they just gave me a DUI in court. I need a drink.
Bitch, my doctor just told me my kidneys was bad. I need a drink.
Girl, I'm pregnant. Bitch, I need a drink.
Ayo, why niggas think dick is the answer to everything? It could be a million things going wrong. So you type this nigga a whole 6-page paragraph expressing to this nigga how you feeling. So if you got iPhone, you see those 3 dots of carriage, you think the nigga about to explain some shit. But the message come through and it say, oh, I know what's wrong with you. I know what's wrong. You need some act right. But whatever, he's so crazy. So we go ahead and give him some. But after that, everything is still the same. Like it was before the dick.
You still don't clean up after yourself. You still ain't take the trash out. You still ain't wash the tub out. The bitch is still calling you. You still lying. You still ain't post me. You still ain't get my nails done. You still here. Dick is not the solution, okay? Dick is a distraction. Ayanla, Dick. Ayanla, Dick. Which one you think out here fixing lives? Alright.
He's gonna kill her. I mean, you see what that family does to people. Oh my God, Jess with the Mess. Catch the new season premiere of Snapped. First episode is a 3-hour special on Rob Kardashian. Apparently, he's had enough of Black China's disrespect. He has posted nudes of her and also a video of her with another guy. This guy's Black, right? But apparently the guy is broke and asking Rob for money. Wait, this guy's Black, right? Ooh, oh my God, I was gonna say, I don't know too many white broke guys. So sorry. Yes, I do. But Black China has Snapchats claiming that Rob beats her. That guy wouldn't kill a chicken. He would just eat it. So sorry. Rob keeps ranting and raving about how he just can't believe she would do something like this. That's just like saying, what? Love and Hip Hop is scripted? Rob and China must have another show coming out. Meanwhile, Ghost is still in jail, and so is Bonnie Bella. Her parents are nuts.
And we're back. This is Jess with a Mess. And I'm here live with devastated Rob Kardashian. Say hi, Rob. Rob claims that China had a butt reduction. Well, that's certainly a procedure you don't have to worry about your sisters getting. I am so sorry, Rob. Rob also explained how the doctor messed up on China's nipples after the last surgery that he paid for. Okay, so Rob, I saw the pictures of the nipple, and her nipples aren't too big. I think you meant the areolas, which is the dark area around the nipple. Did you see my nudes? Because mine are big too. So just what the fuck are you trying to say? I don't care whether it's Black China or Black Japan. If the bitch is Black, her areolas are big. Now, there's a big difference between loving somebody and being weak. Where do you feel you fit in? Well, never mind. You don't have to answer that. We all have vaginas at some point. It's okay. Rob also reveals that Black China's doing all of this because she's mad that Kylie stole Tyga. So you've been feeling like this the whole time? I mean, I beg to differ. Nobody wants Tyga. Not even Kylie. Not even Birdman.
Good afternoon, it's Jess with a Mess. Rapper T.I. had a lot of words about Rob Kardashian. Why bring your business to IG, bro? You got worked. And now you're showing the world that you're a duck. A big duck. A mighty duck. Ronald McDonald. Save your ducktails and take the L. You have no more moves, bro. I got this one. But you're married. And you're a thought. A big thought. Super duper thought. Fucking these strippers, you a thought, thought, thought. Has Tiny come back yet? Or did she escape? So sorry. Everybody is still in awe about how Rob didn't see this coming at all. How could you not see it all from the beginning? Kim Kardashian's your sister! I mean, your whole senses should be sharp by now. Oh, come on. What, because she's married with 2 kids, her wholeness has been deleted? You remember the last girl that said that? I'm sorry, a body count is a record that cannot be expunged. Boo, you can't unfuck people. As far as Rob and China, no one rooted for this! We never rooted for this! Learn from your sisters! Sorry.
And somehow, we just keep coming back. I better be getting paid for this shit. It's Jess with a Mess. Rob Kardashian airs dirty laundry about threesomes that Black China had with T.I. and Tiny after T.I. decided to chime in and speak on Rob's daughter.
Oh, 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 oh.
What did T.I. say?
See, I have no recollection of this sexual exchange Rob speaks of.
Oh, I? You definitely do. Lil Wayne announces that he finally will be dropping the Carter. Sorry, Wayne, I'm gonna let you finish. But I think Rob and China had the biggest news of all day. Back to Rob and China. Rob hires his sister's father's lawyer, the same lawyer that got OJ off. Oh, Chloe's dad. I was like, what? That means China will have to go back to the strip club. Should have been more like the Puerto Rican princess. Wait, we should warn 21 Savage. You know Amber are best friends with her. Oh, wait, what am I talking about? 21 Savage isn't even scam worthy. Now, I know it's like human nature for us folk to refer to some people as animals. Like, for instance, you might call a snitch a rat. Y'all call sneaky people snakes. But what the fuck is a duck? Everybody kept calling Rob a duck today. He a little too big to be a duck. I never heard that shit till today. I don't even understand where y'all got rat from. I never seen a rat take the stand. Unless you Dr. Doolittle, rats don't talk. I mean, I feel like you should just call it like you see it. Why a duck? Call him something that fits him. He's big and white. Albino gorilla. If he was skinny and white, a straw. I guess because duck is the weakest bird or something. But if that's the case, it's a pigeon, not a duck. And why do guys call hoes birds? What does a hoe and an actual bird have in common? Hoes don't fly, but what does a hoe and an actual bird have in common? We see dogs fuck all day. Rabbits, horses. Shit, I even seen three flies have a threesome in my windowsill. But when the last time y'all seen birds fuck? Good morning, everybody. I know I'm supposed to be funny for y'all. And I'm going to get to it. Don't worry about it. But I just got something quick to say in regards to Rob. I kept saying shit yesterday like, yo, a whole bitch. That's why you can't love bitches. I don't love bitches. I never let a bitch do me like that. He a whole sucker out here. That's why I treat bitches like I treat bitches. Yo, got what he deserve. Damn, how can you really say that about somebody? This man wasn't raised in a fuck bitches get money home. You feel me? Every nigga not like that. This nigga's actually a lover. He was in love with her. He just kept taking her back. I wouldn't say he a duck. I wouldn't even say he's stupid. If that's the case, half the bitches following me stupid. If that's the case, I've even been stupid a time or two. For instance, T.I., how many times you cheat on Tiny? How many times? And she took you back. It's just the last time was too much. That's basically what he just did. All I'm saying is all you niggas run around talking about money over bitches, and half you niggas ain't even got no fucking money. Or no bitches. Yeah, he got played, but he still got money. A lot of it, and I want it.
Don't y'all hate when a bitch always got something to say about somebody else, but she ain't even got her own shit together? Bitch, what the hell?
Did you see me on Wildin' Out last night? No, mine came on at 11:30. What? Whoa, I was funny. What are you talking about? It was dry. Girl, your mother not even on TV, so yeah, don't judge me. Judge your mother. What? I mean, ridiculousness, okay. Don't nobody even really watch that. She was on that one clip with me. What you mean? When she went to buy them ugly ass shoes. She not on Wildin' Out, though. Looking at me like that, I'll send your ass home. I'll mail you home. Put you in the mailbox. What you thought this was? Little rude ass. That's why I don't deal with babies now. Y'all always trying to be smart every time. You didn't even, girl, you not even.
Okay, let me take a break. Let me get back to the promo. Let me get back to the tour date. So listen, I told y'all yesterday, July 16th, where I'm going to be, Tennessee. I'm coming your way, but I ain't let y'all know where I was coming on the 17th. On the very next day, the 17th, y'all can catch me. Give me the drum roll. Huntsville, Alabama at Stand Up Live. Oh my God, I can't wait to come down to Alabama. That's all the way down south. I might get down there and see some of my cousins I ain't never known I had. Shit, y'all got me about to hop on Ancestry.com. Check this out, Alabama, I'm coming, so show me some big love. Get your tickets at www.huntsville.standuplive.com. Goddamn, goddamn. Showtime is at 7 p.m. And listen, I ain't never been there before, so y'all know y'all better have my fried chicken wing. Get your tickets now, like I said, www.huntsville.standuplive.com. July 17th, 7 p.m., I see y'all there.
Hold up, is that a cavity?
Damn.
I was cruising down the street, four deep. Three bitches, one yapper on me. And a yapper might well be a fee. Cause it got two arms and some feet. Cause it wake up in the morning and it eat. I love my chopper and I think it love me.